Okay, everybody.
Hello.
I'm gonna reduce it. Oh, I can't reduce it anymore. Okay. I'm just gonna get going here. Are we live? Right there. Okay. So, hi, everybody. I just wanted to say welcome to the class today. If you haven't joined before, today we are going to be doing, today we are going to be doing a scenery. Right, so it was a busy morning for me, so I was all over the place. Just got back just in time. So here we are. I've got a really simple board from Dollarama. Now, I did hear from Leslie Ann, and she said, "Hi, Trisha." Yeah, you're live, Lou. Yes, I thought I wasn't for a minute. Very tech savvy. On, off. Go. So I heard from Leslie Ann yesterday that because some of the stores are closed, that you don't have access to some supplies. So what I am saying is that even if you couldn't find a board, right? That's my cousin, Trisha. So even if you don't have supplies, what you can do is you can have an old gift bag. I'm just gonna pop this on the side here. Whoops. Oh, what a noise. What a loud sound. Okay, so if you don't have a board and you don't have Bristol board, what you can do is you can have a gift bag. And the gift bag tends to be, hi, Antonio, that's my boss there. He knows that I'm working. So I have Wednesdays off. And so so today, what I was saying is you could take a gift bag. And the gift bag, you can turn it over. What? LOL. Oh, yes, please tell Solange to come. And Nikolai, my nephew, sort of nephew. So you could take a gift bag, turn it on the inside out, and you can cover a piece of cardboard, like a cardboard box. And that would certainly be sufficient for your surface that you're working on today. So what I'm going to do is, because I have an easel, I'm going to use the easel. So I'm just going to pop this up here, and I'm wondering if that's close enough. I think that might be close enough. I might shake the camera a bit with pushing you a little bit closer. So just give me a second. And I will organize this. Oh, not very successfully. You should see my tripod setup. How's that? A little bit better? Right. Okay. So what we're going to do today is we have an assortment. My face is too close. Anyway, whatever it is. I'm gonna try my best to not be in there too much. So what we're gonna do is today, hi Danique, my cousin, hi darling. Last week I wasn't live as I was scheduled to be. So it ended up being a recorded session, but now I'm live like City TV, according to our local news station. Okay, so what we're going to do is just any random brushes that you have, right? Hi, Beth. Nice to see you. So we have some random brushes. It doesn't matter if you don't have all the brushes, but let's try and just get going, okay? Hi, Solange. Hi, darling. Hi, Danique, my beautiful cousin. Everybody in Trinidad, I hope everybody's doing very well. I have, I can't say I'm total in isolation, but pretty much in isolation up here. I went out to the store, and when I was out there, just for precautionary measures, I have something in my hair, which is a bandana. This bandana. Actually, it's a stretchy bandana. This is a super easy diversion. This is how I go shopping. And it's a scarf. But for me, I'll just put it right back where it is. Okay. Good $1.25. All right, so getting back to our work here. Okay, so what we have here is we're gonna put a series of paints on our easel here. I'm gonna put yellow, orange. Now I know not everybody has the correct colors, but what we're gonna try and do is work with what we have. For example, if you have green and white and black, and that's all you have, that will be a monochromatic color scheme. So we'll just work with those range of colors. Yes, you're welcome, Danique. So, and I'm just gonna take the colors that I have, because these are the ones that I have. Because I'm an artist, I have too many. And so sometimes it's hard for me to choose the colors, but today I'm just gonna go with some standard colors that everyone may have, hopefully. So green, yellow, now it's got a red here, and I'm just gonna put them in my tray, a little red, right? And some orange, which don't really have orange, don't need orange. I'll just mix yellow and red to make orange, because all my little followers know, like Solange knows. I know, Mary Lou, what to mix. And my friend Nikolai, I have three colors of the yellow and the red, so I'm just gonna use the three I have. Now, if you don't have, remember what I said, it could be a monochromatic color scheme. Monochromatic meaning white, black, blue. Use what you have rather than worrying about what you don't have. Because sometimes when you end up having three colors of the same tone, like dark blue, light blue, whitish, ends up being just as lovely, if not nicer. So we're just gonna move along. So I don't really know how many people are gonna be watching this. I'm gonna do a very general landscape. It's gonna be a graded landscape, and we're gonna have like the sunshine beaming from the back. And it's gonna go from, we're gonna choose a line, which means I'm going to add black to my color palette just because I'm extra, right? And that's the way I have it. Not much, I don't need much, but I will later. So you see here, I've got light yellow, mid, just because I have it, yellow and red primaries. Usually people have primaries. They have a yellow-ish, a red-ish, and they have a blue-ish. Sometimes you have green, sometimes you have black. I just happen to have all the basic ones, and I'm using the basic ones because I want everyone to feel that they are capable of doing these very simple projects with some basic stuff. Okay, moving forward, I'm just using this brush. Try not to use anything too fancy, because I don't want anyone saying, oh, but I didn't have the fancy stuff, so I'm just gonna go with whatever I've got. So you take the brush, dip it in the water a little bit, get it a little wet, And we're gonna do a little bit of a basic sketch on here. Very simple. I'm gonna take a little bit of my black and I'm gonna put a little bit of the green, black and green mixed, sort of like a deep, deep, and I'm gonna take some blue and I'm gonna put it in there. Now, for those who don't have paint, you can use these basic colors and do a pencil crayon rendering with the same, okay? So we're just gonna go ahead. Lydia, hello. So, instead of going straight in half, you don't wanna cut any board straight in half or any painting straight in half. What we're gonna do is we're gonna go one third up, thank you, and then we're gonna go two thirds. So basically, if you do not know how to measure, you take something very scientific, like an item, any item, put it next to it, choose a line. I'm gonna choose the lid line. See how scientific that is? And I'm gonna move it down, join it, move it down, join it. It's called math on the go. So I'm just gonna go, whoops. There you go, wow, super wow. The kids following you now, okay. Hi there, Sharma, hello. Okay, so basically the color I ended up getting there is kind of like a muddy blue type of color. And because everybody's cooped up indoors and everybody wants to be at the beach, this is gonna be kind of like a beachy kind of a feel, okay? And this is my son Sebastian bringing me, oh, he doesn't want to pop in here, never mind. Can you back that up a little bit, bud? Just a little bit. No, hold the tripod, pull it back. A little bit more. Okay. Watch that. Okay, perfect. Okay. And tilt it a little bit up. Pow. All right. Thank you, Sebastian. So I've got this color, like I said. This kind of like weird, sort of like black, green, blue-ish type of a color. And it's not rocket science. It's whatever comes out, okay? Hello, Lee Evans Gray. My gosh, she is so lovely. That woman, Lee Evans Gray, has the most spectacular photographs in the world. I love, love, love. Nice hot cup of tea. So moving along here, I'm using a little bit of a wet technique. Right, so because I've got that murky color in the back, I'm going to basically just continue on side to side, dry, wet, what have you. I'm gonna add a little bit of water and I'm gonna just have it run down like that. Across and back. If you have white, I suppose I can get a white at this time. And I don't have white, and I'm not running off to grab white. I have a light blue, I'm gonna use that one. Yeah. How is the tea? Oh, the tea is fabulous. During the day, I might as well be a little old lady in a rocking chair. I'm a big teetotaler in the day. Except when I'm on vacation with my cousins. My cousins have a different way of, you know, it's either water for Trisha or beer for Sean. So I'm gonna take this blue, which if you don't have a light blue, you use, you're gonna use a white mixed in with your blue to create a light blue. If you don't have that, just use something light. If you have a light gray, use a light gray and mix it with the blue, that's fine. So So you see what I've done? I've just mixed in this blue straight out of the tube. And because my brush is muddy, it's got some metal of color in there. I'm just gonna go from the bottom. Ah, beautiful. And I'm just gonna go side to side. Use your body and sway in there. I quite like the white showing through. Hi, Anita. How's my girl? Everybody lock up home. So I have the light blue. If you don't have light blue, use white, mix it with your blue, and that will be your lightish color. No, I have something else in this pile of whatever. We're gonna go with what I have, right? Okay, so I've got my blue. And it had a muddy nature of the dark blue in the background. You can just add a little bit, piff, piff, like that, piff, piff. I'm gonna bring it close so you can see it. So that's what it looks like right now. Okay, you've got the dark blue with a little water in it. Started to, hi Chris, Christopher. It had the dark blue here, and then I started with the light blue that I had from the bottle, from the jar, and then I sort of muddied it and mixed it, left a little bit of the white inside of here somewhere. Okay, we're gonna go with that. This is just to remind us that everybody needs something to look forward to. The sea, beautiful stream. I mean, water in general is just so spectacularly open to our minds and our imagination. Just continuing to bless us with openness. It opens our minds. And women especially, we are... Water, we are water, we are power, and our water is our power. So when I go to the beach, or when I go to a river, might as well be baptized every time. I go to the water, and I dip that finger, I give myself a little blessing. It's that revive. And I don't care about the toxicity in the water, as people say, the pollutants, because I figure, you know what? I'm not dying anytime soon. Okay. Oh, Trishan from Windsor. That's my friend. Okay, so I've got my blue. I've left some whiteboard there. That's gonna be very nice. Yes, Danique, you are gonna get through. We're all gonna get through. And I'm not gonna talk about the spiritual nature of getting through, because this is a painting session. It's not a crying session. So, we're all gonna get through. You have to think positive. Think positive. Let's not go there in our negative thoughts, because it's our positive thoughts, our positive visualization, our positivity that generates, and that vibration will be contagious. Contagious to your family, contagious to your friends, contagious to everyone. You have to instill that positive power with your children, with your neighbors, with your family, with your loved ones. You pick up that phone and you just give them some positivity. No negativity. No. Okay, let's get back to the project. You're welcome, Danique. So, I'm gonna take this paintbrush. It's kind of like a house paintbrush, but not. Or it's like a super small brush that nobody ever uses when they say, oh, there's paintbrushes for a kit for trim and wall painting. Everybody says, that's too small for the wall, but it's perfect for what we need. And it's a big paintbrush in relative. Okay, relativity. Anyway, let's move on. So, who wants sun up compared to sundown? I kind of think sun up is nice. So what we're going to do is we're just going to have a ray of sun. This is just going to be a beaming happy picture. I'm going to take my yellow, which is what I have in place of white. And I'm just going to just go in there side to side and push it there. And I'm going to go right along the bottom with my light yellow. Okay? Sun up. Yeah, man. And I'm holding my brush on the side like this for going side to side. And when I'm doing the bigger area, I'm holding it like that. So this for lines and this for side to side. Okay? A little water just to have that fluidity. And it'll also have that sort of like that little runny watercolor-ish feeling rather than thick paint. So side to side. If you want to be clever, you can leave a tiny white line between the yellow and the blue. And you're moving along. And I'm gonna just start to show you basically how that looks, right? Just beginning. Okay, dip my brush a little bit of water, and I'm just gonna keep going with that little I'm listening to Post Malone. He's a bit of a punk, but I like him because he's like trim brush. Yeah, that's right, Trishan. So Post Malone is this 24-year-old young, very, very tattooed young man, 24. But I'll tell you, he has gotten me through some rough times. Everybody likes music, right? Hi, Marlene. So, everybody needs music to lift your spirit through a very difficult period in your life. And everybody remembers, you know, when you're going back to your high school days or you're going back to some kind of period, or even the young ones who are watching, music makes you happy. So choose music that lifts you or serves a purpose in this point of your life. Like for me, for example, I listen to Post Malone. He's very edgy. People hear me when I do my live sessions. I do them often with him because he's edgy. I think he is a little over the top, but I also think he's got some good depth to him. I won't get too much in detail, but what I'm trying to say is that when you need a gumption that you need to work through, like if you're working out or if you're doing something with conviction, sometimes you just need that type of music to help you reach that more of an aggressive nature. Without being aggressive, you need to take on that spirit of the song itself. Anyway. He's got some positive stuff, some not so positive stuff, but I like him because he gets me through a tough period now and again. All right, let's get back. So we've got our sun up. If we're doing sun up, the lighter sun is going to be at the top and the darker sun is going to be at the bottom. So we're just going to go with a dark. If you have orange, great. If you have red, I kind of just freewheely it. I'm gonna put my brush in the water, put a little bit of the red, mix it in with the yellow to create my orange, and that's what I'm gonna go with. And I'm just gonna start. Don't go quite to the bottom. Lift your brush so that you're dry brushing on the top. and then dry brush it and sway. Get your body in there. So I'm starting with this. See what's happening? So I'm kind of using my base, which is the yellow, and then I'm just meddling in some of the orange. Hey, Sandra. Long time. I'm gonna continue with my light yellow, and then with not washing off what's on my brush, I'm gonna continue with the light yellow, continuing to raise it up higher. Side to side, and blending it up and blending it down. So it's like up and blending it down, up and down, side to side. And if you wanna use this as exercise, do it, girls. Ooh, 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 ooh. So my light yellow, the purest yellow at the top, as soon as I start seeing a little bit of the orange, I go back down to get rid of the orange that's on my brush. And it's not a matter of being lazy, it's just you want to have that blending, that loveliness. I'm going to leave a little bit of the white here, and I'm going to do a little bit of the white fade in there. I'm going to turn it on the side right now like this. And I'm gonna go back to forth, back and forth. You think to yourself, oh my gosh, this is so easy. It is easy. It really is easy. I'm gonna dip my brush right back in that original yellow, a little bit of water, and put it right back into that same yellow. Hello. Hi, Josie, hi. Nice to see you. So again, I'm gonna have my side to side with a little water on my brush into the lightest yellow, and I'm just gonna go side to side and do a little bit of blending. I'm just gonna kiss the side, and then I'm gonna leave this just a little eeps. So you see you have this. If I had white, I'd probably put more white in there, but I don't have white, and not everybody has everything, so you gotta go with what you have. Thank you, Trisha. Thank you. There's something about the way his music is, and actually, I think there was a study done that the rhythm is, I can't say addictive, but there's some component in his music which is seated in our soul, which almost, it's transfixing so many of us. It is easy, Marlene. It is easy. I'm gonna bring it forward for everyone to see that. So, there you have it. You've got your blues with your sort of your wet, how it started to drip. I love a little drip. And then I started to wash it side to side. I chose my very, very structural line by aligning the tube of the paint and then making a line going across. Started with the yellow and then went in with the orange. And then side to side, side to side, side to side, left some of the raw canvas in there. If you have white, you could put white in there. That's even lovelier. No worries. So here we go, everybody. I'm gonna leave this just like that, right? Okay, so we're gonna take our lightest color now. Sorry, our darkest color. I'm rinsing off my brush. The same very simple brush, right? washing it thoroughly, looking for a rag. There's got to be a rag here somewhere. Of course. Oh my goodness.
There we go.
All right. When you go from one stage to another, it's almost like a cleanse. You want to clean your brush and get it ready. Okay, so because we are not at the beach and we want to be at the beach, I am going to... You know what I didn't do that I should do? I'm going to take some of that yellow with some thin brush. Any thin brush, right? I'm going to take that yellow and I'm just going to go side to side. First you get your hand in the rhythm, going side to side. And then before you touch down, you just prepare that rhythm. Little water, little yellow, and you go side to side and you go, you kiss it. A little bit. You don't have to have your mouth hanging open like mine. And then I'm going to take the same orange that's here, and I'm going to go side to side, because the sky is blue because it's a reflection of our sea, of our water, right? So, what does it say? We connect with me. Ah, yes. You are so correct. Thank you. Post Malone is a good choice. I love him. I love him in my music box. All right. I don't love his tattoo choices. But every artist has their own thing. I took a tiny bit of red. And I'm going to mix it in with my orange. Right? Just for a little bit of drama. The furthest, deepest color is at the back, okay? Hi, Brent! My cousin-in-law. So I'm gonna take my darkest color, which is the mix of, some yellow in there, but predominantly the red. And I'm gonna go at the very back, and I'm just gonna add a little hint. Just a little line at the back, to bring that sun at that level in the reflection of the water. Okay? Just a little in there. I'm gonna put my darkest red on another area, and then I'm gonna put a tiny bit of the blue. And I'm gonna keep them both on the same brush, just messed up in the same brush. And this is just a cheap brush. This is not no $15 Curry's Art Store brush. This is just a little pack of $5 something brushes. And I'm doing everything that everybody can access, because art is not just for fancy people who have fancy tools. It's for everybody. Okay, so red, a little bit of blue, and a little just... Remember what I said, move your hand back and forth. If you have to rest your hand on something or rest your elbow on something, or if you have to hold your elbow, whatever it takes. Oh, lovely. And then a little somewhere. And another. And don't just do it one after another. It's not stripes. You're not doing stripes. You're not making a pattern on a shirt. Just gonna show you this close. See how nice that is? Just a little hint. Very simple. Very simple. Okay. Right, now that I have that. Right? I'm gonna take my flat brush again. Right? Hi, Mary. Man, oh man, my people coming out today, loving it. I'm gonna take the darkest color I have in the green, okay? And because this is kind of like, let's just say it's a window. We're sitting under the trees. Sun up, right? Like Anita wants. We're gonna take our darkest green, dip our brush right into the water, take our darkest green, pop that there. You could warm it up and put a little red in there. You don't have to. Love the colors. Thank you, Mary. And because we're under these trees and we're just enjoying the scenery, we want to have the trees kind of in kind of like an archway, a halo over us. So we're just going to start with an arched shape, a palm tree shape, and I'm going to start right here. Make sure you've got your green like that. Pull the paint at the very tip of the brush like that, and it's a little watery because I just want to start it with a base, right? Start here and just go all the way down using the edge. I'm going to come over here, hold it over the edge here, and do it twice. Right. And then I'm going to get my black or blue, if you have blue, and then mix it with the same muddy brush, right? And I'm just going to do that. And I'm just going to do a halo on the outside. All right. Okay. Got that. One. I'd like it a little bit wider. So again, you don't just dive in there with the same brush. Get your color, mix it, and then pull it to the tip. So you've got the, and then you pick it up. Right? Right? Got it? And then put it right back on there. And if you're hearing a pitter-patter, you're hearing my dog, Ginger. And you go down and you broaden the end. Ah. See that? That's what it looks like. Okay? So, I'm gonna mix some more of the exact same paint, either like the dark green, dark blue, what you've got. And that's gonna be our palm tree head, okay? Very nice. Okay, moving on. A little water on the tip. Don't make the mistake and take the whole brush and dive it in unless you're cleaning it. And you're gonna make more green. It's got some black in there. Fine. Pull it to the edge. See how much you've got. Another dip. Green. Mix. I'm going to take some of the black and mix it up. Okay? Pull it to the edge. Pull it to the edge. So the only wet full area is at the very end, okay? And then practice doing very shallow arcing C's or humps, okay? And here we go. Practice in the air before you proceed. One, two, three, okay? Try it again. One, two, three, right? Try and create a perfect edge. So So go backwards. Okay? Like that. Now the rest generally can be done two ways. You can take your brush, must leave. Okay, bye. Bye, Lee. See you next time. Thanks for your photography. Love everything about you. Bye, Lee. I saw, by the way, as Lee's leaving, I saw today as I was driving to run an errand, I always contemplate, yes, anything you need, Trishan, anything. As I was driving, I did have my window open, lucky to have a opening at the top of the vehicle, and I saw this beautiful red-tailed hawk again, and I'm telling you, that red-tailed hawk is my totem for difficult times, showing me that it's going to be all right. Everybody has one. You have to look for it, you have to ask for it, and then when it appears, you have to identify it. Seek and you shall find. Okay, going back to this. Pull the paint to the very tip of the brush and then make a couple of lines. Bing, bing, and arc. Arcing, 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 arcing. Just one set so far, right? Next one. Pretend that it's on the other side and do arcing as if you can see the branch on the other side. And go the same way. Cross hatching. So you've got something like that happening. Very simple. I've done one. It's a little wet. It's better to keep going with a wet on wet technique for the branches so that they kind of overlap one another and it's all done same time. So again, pull it to the edge. So the wet paint is at the very tip, so it gives you more control. Okay, I'm going to try this guy over here. I'm just using actually just the end of it this time, just the very end. And again, arching, wet. Okay. I'm going to use the other side now. Same, the same green, the same wet edge. And I'm going to go the other side. Then you can fix it. And of course, my palm tree isn't just three branches of leaves. Hi, Suzanne. Mrs. Anderson, nice to see you again. Well, you're seeing me. I'm not seeing you, but congratulations on your great-granddaughter, yes. Looking forward to seeing her, but I'm happy that I get to see her in pictures. She is absolutely beautiful. And that Jetson looks exactly like Kale. Oh my gosh, it's amazing. It's amazing. So I'm gonna do one more branch out here. And again, if you can use the tip, right? If you can use, hi Kelly. If you can use the tip of the brush and get in there, arcing, 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 arcing. Okay, tip of the brush, wet again, and then. So it's starting to come along. You can do one other thing here. Right? You can add another branch. It's actually just a regular acrylic craft paint, Marlene. Marlene's asking me if it's watercolor. It is acrylic paint from the dollar store or from Deco Art, which is Michael's, but it's all craft paint, Americana craft paint. And I just watered it down to give it a little bit more of a fluidity rather than just using it straight out of the tube or straight out of the jar, giving it a little bit of a watery consistency. So if you want to use the term watercolors, sure, sure. So we've got our tree. I would actually go one step further and add one extra branch, and it has to be a very sharp arc this time, okay? Yes, Anita, you need to get some supplies, my girl, because if we're going to be doing this week after week, you better get going. So far we have this. I'm going to have one more branch, sort of as if it's coming towards us, and you have to either use the tip, just the edge of it, or you can curve your brush in a very quick manner. So you have to practice the curve very quickly, like this. Okay, thank you, Leslie Ann. Do it very quickly like that. So make sure it's wet, pull the paint to the very edge, and we're gonna start here and go quick. Okay, and because this branch is coming towards you, I'm going to, okay, that's okay, you have that link, Kelly. So I'm going to just use the very tip now, just the very tip. I'm going to add a little bit of water, not my tea, and I'm going to just make sure you pull the paint to the tip of the brush, keep it wet. And it's coming towards you. And remember what I said, arc. Now, if you have a thinner brush, why, you're in business, man. But just try and get a couple of the hairs of the brush you have and just work your magic like that. A couple of more hanging downs. Like that. And again, practice your hand movement in arcs. Practice it first, use the very tip, and then cross over your trunk a little bit, okay? Now, so peaceful. Now, what we're gonna do is, because this is at a beach, we're sitting somewhere here. We're really enjoying this. This tree is in front of us. Got the sun coming down. We want to have the sun kind of kiss the side of the trunk. But for now, we're going to take, what do we have here? I'm going to use some of the light blue. Some of that light blue that's in there. I'm going to mix it with the same brush. Make it a little bit muddy. I'm going to get some yellow in here. Just using whatever I have. Ends up being a light green. I'm going to use some more yellow. Mix it. I just like to experiment with paint, see what comes up. Now what I have here is this kind of an interesting gray green. And I'm just gonna go down the side of my trunk like that. See that? Yeah. The canvas is out of the frame. Oh, now it's in. Hi, Dorsey. Dorsey James. My goodness. If anybody knows Dorsey, he does the most spectacular carved wood sculptures with so much in-depth and spiritual charm. It's amazing. We can't see the painting. Oh, sorry. Sorry. Pardon me. Here you go. Okay. So you see, that's what's coming here. Got it? There. So I'm going to continue to do this. And can you see the painting now, everybody? Everybody can see it now? Yeah? Okay. Anyway. So I've already done a light green on the edge there just to show a little bit of a lightness to the edge of the palm tree. And I'm going to do the exact same thing with the lightest green, the lightest mushy green that I have here. It was just like pond. Yes. Thank you. So I'm going to take the light green and I'm just going to highlight a few of these branches here. That just a little, I should pull it forward like that. I'm just going to lighten up some of the ones that are coming forward, the ones that overlap, so that it has a little bit of a, see that? So you've got some light ones enhancing the front areas. See that? And the edge of the branch of the palm tree. All right. Yancy! And so I'm going to take the same light yellow and I'm going to just highlight a couple of the branches or the tree leaves in the foreground. We want to have that nice depth of stuff in the background, stuff in the foreground. So you just want a little hint here and there of the lighter color. It just creates a nice little overlap. Not anything spectacular, but the end result is very nice, the overlapping, okay? So, palm trees have this lovely little bit of a ruggedness going down, and I'm gonna take the tip of my brush, and I'm just resting it on there. I'm going down there in a little bit of a manner like that. Okay? See that? Very simple, very lovely. And now what I'm going to do is I am just going to make it a little bit more grassy. I'm gonna take the original green that I had, which was for the trees. I'm gonna change it a little bit. Add some blue. Maximilian. Oh, Mark Anthony, come.
I can't.
No. Just warm up my teeth, please. I'm mixing a blue. And I'm going to take some of my yellow and make this murky green right here. See that? Chitta. I am a millionaire. I have a million something, but I don't know what it is. It ain't money. So, moving along, here we go. I am going to take this beautiful, murky, almost like a khaki, although khaki's banned in Trinidad. Or no, that's camo. Anyways, let's move along. And I am going to take this and I'm going to make arcing, right? And just keep on doing this with the exact same brush. It should be one brush painting. That's what it should be. One brush painting. And we are in this sort of like this little hidden area where you have grasses and the tree leading you out. This is just a little bit of an image in your mind's eye as to where you are. Okay. And I am going to, Mark Anthony, can't get these kids to warm up my tea. All right. And I'm going to have these grasses. It's going to start a little bit. When I find it's getting a little thick, like that, camo, not khaki. Yes, I corrected myself. So I added a little bit of water to that same khaki color, and I'm pulling it to the tip. You have to make sure it goes right to the tip like that. Mark Anthony.
One second.
And then I dip it again and pull it to the edge one more time so that the edge is crisp and thin and wet, okay? Is Max spoiling you? Well, you know, I'll tell you, Sebastian spoiled me today. I went to see Sanders, he's trying to find an apartment. And I went to see Sanders and I bought him some breakfast. And I gave it to him, but because we spent a long time, I gave him both sandwiches. Came home and Sebastian is very proud of himself. He's really taking on a very mature disposition. And he says, Mom, I can make you some breakfast. And I said, okay, you can make me some breakfast. I look forward to it. He made some gourmet breakfast, I'm telling you. It's fantastic. So moving on. Thank you. That's Mark Anthony. Continuing on with our grasses. I'm gonna come closer. And we're in here. We're in this beautiful hidden place, just a little bit ways back from the beach. And we're here. We are watching and waiting and having our Mai Tai and our tea and our coffee and our Kahlua and our Shirley Temple. So these grasses are tall and they're not blocking the tree, but they are in front of our tree, right? Right? And you want to have a nice thicket of lovely grasses. Some falling to the right, some falling to the left. The idea is almost to encompass the base of the tree. You want that level, you want to have that level where you want to feel that depth. So, let me just adjust my chair here. Thank you, Mark Anthony. And off he goes. That's my fuel. Okay. So, we have our grasses on one side. We have our grasses bending forward. See, a naturalized perspective. A little bit more on the right. I'm just doing it a little sort of freehand and close so you can see. You almost want to cover up that whole trunk, right? Yes, Trishan, it is the corona later. Yes, definitely, most definitely. No kids here then. Okay, so we wanna have this grass a little bit on this side too, because you wanna feel that closeness, that comfort, that hidden comfort. And so you do wanna have a little bit of the grasses on this side as well. Right. And again, the arcing. You see? Because you know in your mind, you know your mind is back there. You're where you are. And this is your view from a window. I mean, oh my goodness, you're sitting back in that little lounge chair, Muskoka chair, enjoying this view, and you want to envision what's happening. You want to envision that you're there, this is where you are. That's your little happy place. So I'm going to take a light yellow. Actually, that orangey yellow. I'm going to take this big blob of the orangey yellow and I'm going to mix it in with that murky khaki. Because that's just the way I am. Just mix it in there. Right? And it ends up being this nice, interesting, warm olive green. Okay? Now I'm going to just touch some of the grasses. And I'll show you what I did. You see this? I touched some of the grasses and I brought it down for the simple reason that when you walk by, you're gonna break that tall blade and it's going to just fall forward. Okay? Paint and send it for me. Yes, it can, Trisha. Yes, it can. If you sit down and you just get into that spirit and get that paintbrush. And if you don't have that big paintbrush, by the way, have a little one, right? I'm gonna do it with this little brush. It's easy, easy peasy. I'm gonna wet the brush. I'm gonna dip it into that same yellow murky, right? And I'm gonna do it close. So you see here, I'm gonna pretend I'm coming up and then dip it down. And I'm going to have some of them one. See that? Couple crossing over. Crossing over. A little one kissed by the sun. A little one kissed by the sun. There you have it. Lovely. And then I'm going to do a little bit on that side. You see how flat that side is before the green? And this is after with the light green. Before, after. Okay? And I'll just hold it because it seems to be easier. And I'm just going to hold it right. Maybe I could prop it up on here. And from the side, I'm just going to go zip. And down, couple of crossed blades, wet, and the same principle, by the way, the same principle, this little brush, pull the paint to the tip of the brush so that the tip of the brush has the wet paint, okay? A couple of crossed over. I'm sorry, my music is gone. So you see, a few more of those and you're all done. So it's like almost you can do a one up and then down. A little bit wet. Pull the paint to the tip, up and down. And then a couple more and then it's all done. Very simple. Okay. Mark Anthony?
Sebastian,
can you bring me a toothpick, please? I'm going to get my fancy assistant to bring me a toothpick. Because when you have this kind of a scene, you want to have some birds in the sky. You want to have some life. I know my face is all like bleached out from my lamp here, but it makes me look like I have a facelift, so I'll take it. Okay. Anita, thank you, darling. I'm just going to do the birds with the fancy toothpick, and then our session is done. So far, this is what we have. Right? Thank you, Sebastian. And I have this toothpick, very, very fancy. And I'm going to just kind of rough up the end a little bit. And I'm going to put it in, I don't know, a little bit of that orange color, or maybe a little bit of the red, a little bit of the blue. Ah. And I'm just going to do, oh, that's not going to work. Maybe a little bit of water. Remember, your toothpick has to be a little bit flattened on the end. A little flattened on the end. It can't be. It's almost like a used toothpick. Flatten the tip. Make sure your paint is a little wet-ish. Blue is always lovely. And then do a little bit of an arc. Pretend you're making mustaches. Right? For every little mark, right? You have to dip it once again. And you know, seagulls are annoying. But the more you have in a picture, the better. And there we have it. Now, I'm not going to add anything else like boats or things like that. But you know that if you wanted to add a boat or a lovely little lump of an island in the background, I could carry on all day. But this has to be made easy so everyone feels that it's attainable. So I want everyone to know that this could be you. You can do this. You just sit down, have a good attitude, have water, something lovely beside you, a little cup of tea, and this could be yours for free. So thank you, Trishan. Thank you, Trisha, and Brent, and Yancy, and oh my gosh, everybody. I hope everybody enjoyed it. Thank you so much. And believe you me, you sit down with a little bit of paint and a canvas, or even if you want to paint a tile, if you don't feel like being, you know, adventurous and painting something big, you have a piece of tile that's in your garage. The inside of a bag, something small so that you feel that you're non-threatened by something. But sometimes when you do some painting on an item that is too small, it ends up being that the fat brush makes it just not possible to have the success. So please, everybody, take some time, add some art in your life. Spend some time with art and you will see that it brings you such a beautiful level of therapy. It's therapy. Everybody knows when I turn on my camera and the music is going, and sometimes when I paint, I don't even sometimes really acknowledge the camera there because I'm in that mode of therapy. And I turn on the camera because I know that some people, by watching me as a fish in a tank, it helps them have their level of therapy in a way that they see something creating, something being created live, and something that is experienced for the first time for you and for me, right? Because obviously if it's white and it starts white and then it turns into color and leaves and pond and what have you, it's really quite spectacular. Everybody, thank you for joining me today. I know the session's a little bit long, but that's what happens when you do too much. Okay, bye everybody. Enjoy. Art is therapy. Therapy is art. Painting is therapy. Therapy is painting. Okay. Bye for now.